Welcome to Road Notes. I'm Mark, and in this episode, we want to discuss a little bit about our, see them here in the background, our e-bikes. We've been now asked a couple of times, how do we not only secure our e-bikes, but also what kind of rack do we use? We've been seeing lately on social media and also on other YouTube videos and channels, a lot of issues with securing e-bikes. You know, they do weigh a lot. Not any bike rack will do. So I'm gonna show you guys what we do, how we secure it, and whether it's right or wrong. But you know what? It works. We have not had any issues. So stay tuned. I will be right back. Okay, first off, our e-bikes. As you can see, we have two e-bikes. One that is a mountain bike style by E-Ahora that has a pretty good little crossbar here. But then we also have Leslie's e-bike that is a step-through e-bike that does not have the crossbar here that goes across. So, and we've been seeing issues with securing those bikes when there are step-through. Okay, this is our bike rack. We have a bike rack that is made by Rola, R-O-L-A, and it's the Convoy model. The way they come is, when you purchase them, you buy one rack for one bike, and then just like a waterfall, you can buy an attachment for it, and you can add as many racks as you want. I'm gonna have the link to this particular rack in the descriptions below. And for the ones that don't know, I'm an avid cyclist, and I've been through a few bike racks in my life, not for e-bikes, but for regular bikes, because we carry these two bikes, and then I also have a road slash gravel bike that I carry with me on my car. And in a little while, I'm going to show you that rack and how it really differs from this one. So this one, really, when I shopped for it, it was important that it is made for heavy duty bicycles, especially e-bikes. So most of the racks that you see online, they do say they carry 50-60 pounds, but what I'm looking for in a good bike rack for my e-bikes is also the frame construction. And a lot of times I see inch and a quarter frame constructions. It just will not do for me. I'm looking for at least a 2-inch, if not bigger, frame that is really, really sturdy. So this bike rack, I think it's about 60 pounds rated for the bike, but the overall construction, the way this bike rack is, it's like 150, 160 pounds. So it's as solid as can be. And, you know, when you load up a bike, an e-bike that is between 40 and 60 pounds, so you are looking to carry 120 pounds already. I obviously want to have a little bit more weight capacity than maxing it out all the time. So I'm going to show you how this rack works next. Okay, so this is the rack in its completely closed up position. So we have a couple of places where you can secure the back tire, and then obviously a nice sturdy rack for the front tire that is really secure. And then what holds it all together are these crossbars that slide down. So right now it's completely closed up. In order to open this, I pull this lever right here, and then you can fold this up and it locks into place. Now each of these levers have a little foam right here to protect your crossbar on your bike. It has a mechanism that slides it up and down for your crossbar, and that also has a locking mechanism. So once you're down on your crossbar, you can to make it double secure, you can pull this down. Once it's in place, you can pull this down and it locks it into place, and now it cannot move anymore. You can simply press in and it unlocks it. This rack also comes with a set of keys, so once you have it down on your crossbar, you can actually secure this and make it anti-theft protected. Same mechanism for the back bike, since we have two bikes. We're gonna unleash these loops here so we can put our back tire into it. Okay, and here, this is what I mentioned earlier. This construction, you know, I want this to be nice, thick, and sturdy. All metal construction. Very solid crossbars here, all the way down to the hitch receiver. This is a 2-inch receiver. And you see these holes? This bike rack can absolutely be adjusted to any length of bike. So you can move this portion back and forth. In terms of fitting it correctly for your bike. Okay, and as I mentioned before, I carry another bike with us on my car, and I'm gonna show you that bike rack next. Okay, so this is my other bike that I use for exercise. It's a road slash gravel bike, and it's a completely different rack here. So if you look at the construction here, it's much thinner diameter wise and it's also not, I mean, yes, it's metal and plastic, and I think it's even plastic, much more wiggly. But you know what, this works fine for a bike like this. You know, this bike is like 18 pounds, so this is no problem carrying this bike. But if you start putting e-bikes on here that are between 45 and 60 pounds, you're gonna experience some issues. And I think this is mainly what we see on a lot of social media posts and other videos with people that have had issues with transporting their e-bikes, because they end up getting a bike rack that is like this. You know, this is 1.25-inch diameter frame, not very sturdy for, you know, 1 or 2 e-bikes that are 120 plus pounds. So now you've seen the two differences on the racks, and the only other difference is, of course, price. You know the old saying, you get what you pay for? Well, it's the same with bike racks. You know, the one for my car, relatively inexpensive bike rack, you probably get it between $80 and $110, something like that. The one for our e-bikes in the back, you know, that one is, I believe, $250 or $300 per each bike, so per platform. So it's a little bit more expensive, but it's gonna protect your investment of an e-bike that cost you, you know, $1,000 and up. Plus, obviously, safety on the road is very important. You do not wanna lose an e-bike on the road. You want it to be sturdy. So I'm gonna show you how I load up my e-bikes next. So before I even load up our bikes, I prepare our bikes. And the first thing I do is I am taking out the batteries. The batteries are anywhere from 15 to 20 pounds. So anything that makes it easier, not so much for the rack because I know I can carry it, but for me, I don't wanna have to carry a 65 pound bike up on that rack. They're heavy enough as they are without the battery. So when we travel, our batteries are off the bike and they are stored in one of our bays. Okay, the next thing that I'm doing is I'm gonna prepare Leslie's e-bike, because as I mentioned before, it is a step through. And when I put it on the bike rack, remember it has the little crossbar secure thing, and I wanted to be able to secure it to the crossbar on my bike rack. So we have a crossbar bar that goes onto that e-bike, and I'm going to show you how to install it. And again, there'll be a link in the description as to where you can purchase this. Really cheap, it's like between $10 and $15. You can buy it at Walmart or order it from Amazon. Okay, another thing that's helping me hoist up the bike to that rack is my trusted little step ladder, two-step ladder. Again, that way I don't have to lift up the bike so high to get up on that rack. Did you guys catch it? Did you catch it? If you didn't, I'm gonna explain. I was talking about for the step-through bike's crossbar that we installed. Most bike racks will have their tie down coming down right here on your crossbar. And that doesn't work well with step-through bikes. Now that's one of the reasons we ended up buying the Rolla Convoy bike rack, because for step-through bikes that don't have crossbars, you can still secure your bike because it's being secured by the front tire. Ha! How cool is that? But the crossbar that we install, or I installed here, still serves a enormous role, and I'm going to show you why next. I'm going to use this little tie down here to secure the bikes better to the rack. Even though the bikes are pretty secured right now, you know, they do move around a lot. They do have a lot of play here, which I don't particularly like when we travel. But believe me, these bikes are secured. But just for extra measure, I put a tie down, which is where the crossbar comes in handy, because now I can tie both bikes together. See this right here? Which really makes for a sturdy, sturdy travel day with our bikes back here. As you can see now, these bikes, they're not going anywhere. Nice and secure. Okay, there's one thing left to do, and that is to cover them up. We always ride, or we travel with our bikes covered up. So we're gonna use our step ladder again, because the higher we can get up now, the easier it will be to throw a cover over top. Okay, and this is our cover for the e-bikes in the back. Doesn't typically get too windy back there. So this is actually it's a motorcycle cover. And because of a motorcycle cover being obviously bigger than an e-bike, one of those motorcycle covers is the perfect size for two e-bikes. Last thing that I use is a little ratchet tie down to make it really, really secure. Okay, this is the finished product. These bikes are now as secure as they can be. They're covered up, protected from the elements, I used the little ratchet tie down to really secure the, not the bike so much, but the bike cover. Doesn't have to be super tight, but just tight enough. And just word to the wise, when you do put on this ratchet tie down, make sure back here you kind of feel it where the headlamps are or your headlights for the bike. You don't put it right on top. Either put it below or above it, otherwise you will break your headlamps. So this is it, guys. The only thing left to do is I also cover up my bike in the front, and I use a little bit of a different bike cover for this one. And it's a bike cover made by Pro Bike Tool, and they make two different kinds. They make a stationary or a garage cover, and they make a travel cover. Since our car's being pulled behind the RV, I opted out, of course, for the travel cover. It's not only more heavy duty, but it also gives you some really, really cool tie down features. So if you have maybe just one bike, maybe it's not even an e-bike, this is the cover I would definitely recommend. Again, I'm gonna have a link in the description below to this cover here. This has been the best bike cover I have ever had for my bike. So let's put that baby on and we'll be ready to go. So as you can see, this bike cover has some really cool features. It has a front tie already built in. It has a top tie built in, and of course one on the back that keeps it pretty nice for windy days. And of course on the bottom you can tie, have some straps here that go all the way through. You can tie them down to really make them secure for travel days. But when it's just here sitting at the RV site, I just keep the bike cover on. But I do make sure I do secure those straps right here, because we do get windy days and I don't want it to be blowing off or get too much wind underneath it. So this is a very, very good bike cover. They do say it's for two bikes, and by looking at the size of it, they are probably correct. Not sure if it's good enough for two e-bikes, but for two regular bikes, I would say it is big enough. Okay, this was it. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was somewhat informative. If you like this video, if you have any questions about the bike rack that we use, the covers that we use, the crossbar that we use, or how we secure it, or maybe any other questions that come to mind when it comes to these e-bikes and bike racks, I will do my best to answer them. Just leave us a message below. Leave us a comment if you like this video. Thumbs up. If you're new to our channel, please consider subscribing, because we have a new video for you every week. And go to our website, roadnotesrv.com. We have some really cool Road Notes apparel. We have some passion gear apparel, like this cool shirt right here, a passion for cycling. But there are so many other passions that we offer in our apparel store. So check it out at mypassiongear.com. But you can also get access through our website at roadnotesrv.com. Once again, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you guys next week. Drive safe. Take care. Bye.